falling of a leaf, like the binding of a sheaf in time. Fleeting days are telling fast that the die will soon be cast, and the fatal line be passed, be in time. Be in time, be in time, while the voice of Jesus calls you, be in time. If in sin you long await, you may find no open gate, and your cry be just too late, be in time. Sinner, heed the warning voice, make the Lord your final choice, then all heaven will rejoice, be in time. Come from darkness into light, come let Jesus make you right. Come receive his life tonight, be in time. Be in time, be in time, while the voice of Jesus calls you, be in time. If in sin you long await, you may find no open gate, and your cry be just too late, be in time.
Welcome. Thank you again this day for coming to listen to our devotionals. My name is Sami Richara, and before I begin, I'd like us to have a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for another opportunity to listen to your word. We pray that you may speak to our hearts, that, Lord, you may convict us with your spirit, that we may learn from you and learn the right path. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Today we speak about repentance. Repentance. How does a man make his way right with Christ? How do you make your life right with God? We know that we are drawn to God by His Spirit, and by Christ we are counted righteous. How do you come to Christ? When the disciples were preaching, the people asked them, they were convicted. In the book of Acts chapter 2, verse 37 and 38, they asked the following question. Now when they heard this, they were pricked in their heart and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what shall we do? Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. And so when you've reached that message, when that message has hit your heart and you've been convicted, we are told that we should repent. But what is repentance? Repentance is defined as a sorrow for sin and a turning away from it. We should sorrow for our condition, the condition that we have been convicted of, and we should want to turn away from it. There are cases of false repentance. We have the case of Esau. Esau was destined to be the inheritor of the birthright. But because of a morsel of food, he sold his birthright to his brother, Jacob. And when the dad was to give his blessings,
Jacob, of course, through deception, got his blessings. And when Esau came back from hunting, he realized that he had
forfeited the inheritance. And so Esau was very bitter. He tried, he repented with a lot of diligence, but it was too late. He could not get it back. His repentance was not because he loved the responsibility of the birthright, but he liked the benefits. We also have another case of repentance that was not genuine, and this was Balaam. And God, when the people, Balak sent his people to look for Balaam to go and come and curse the Israelites, we find that God told Balaam, don't go with those people. But Balaam really wanted the benefits of the work that he was to do. And so he tried all ways, and God told him, all right, you can go. But when he met with the angel on the road, after his donkey had complained that he's beating him, Balaam was terrified because he thought he's going to die. And so we can see there his repentance was not genuine. Another person is Judas. Judas betrayed Christ, thinking that Christ will do a miracle to save himself. And when Christ didn't do it, he realized that Christ was going to be crucified. He was terrified and he wanted to return the money that he had been paid. But the Pharisees told him, no, we don't want the money. And so he realized the mistake he had done and he went and committed suicide. That was false repentance. But what's genuine repentance? Genuine repentance is when you have a sincere sorrow for that sin and you don't want to do it again. We find that in Psalms 51, the prayer of David. Change in me, give me a clean heart, O Lord, and make a right spirit within me. And that is the kind of genuine repentance that we should be looking for. The other thing about repentance is that when you are convicted, when you've got that message that you need to change a certain aspect of your life, do not delay. Because you never know. It could be today. Tomorrow you may not be there. The opportunities you have today, you may not have them tomorrow. We are told in the book, 2 Corinthians, Steps to Christ, we are told, page 32, that
beware of procrastination. Do not put off the work of forsaking your sins and seeking purity of heart through Jesus. Here is where thousands upon thousands have erred to their eternal loss. I will not here dwell upon the shortness and uncertainty of life. But there is a terrible danger, a danger not sufficiently understood, in delaying to yield to the pleading voice of God's Holy Spirit, in choosing to live in sin, for such this delay really is. Sin, in however small it may be esteemed, can be indulged in only at the peril of infinite loss. What we do not overcome will overcome us and work out our destruction.
And so, when you have that point of conviction, don't delay. The more you delay, the harder it will become for us. It says further on down that every act of transgression, every neglect or rejection of the grace of Christ is reacting upon yourself. It is hardening the heart, depraving the will, benumbing the understanding, and not only making you less inclined to yield, but less capable of yielding to the tender pleadings of God's Holy Spirit. Okay? And so we are told here that Christ is willing to set us free. He wants to give us freedom from the sins that ensnare us.
2 Corinthians 6 verse 2 says, behold, now is the accepted time. Behold, now is the day of salvation. And Hebrews 3 verse 7 and 8 says, today, if you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
It is my prayer, friend, that when that message comes to you, do not delay. For tomorrow, we don't know what happens. It is my prayer that you have a good week and that the Lord may continue to guide you in the paths of repentance. God bless you.
Almighty Father.